how to approach mains examination. Many people have been asking me, sir, why don't you tell what we have to do, what we are not supposed to do? You do everything which gets you mark. Don't do anything which deviates you, which ensures that you don't get any mark. Simple, but it is very difficult to understand. Normally people think that the mains IAS examination is like a battle. Is it not? They think that we go just without any planning, just we do whatever it comes. Then of course we come, if you are doing it better now, so okay. Otherwise next year we will do well. Like this they used to think. How we have to approach this exam is that with a lot of planning we have to approach this examination. Now you see, unlike the preliminary examination, the mains examination is more tedious. I do not know whether you know it or not. To know it, actually you have to write one mains, because many people, they don't understand what I am telling. It is so taxing, physically it is very taxing. You please understand this. 3 hours you have to write. In the test itself you are not writing 3 hours properly. You come half an hour late, you go half an hour early. 2 hours you write. That also you will take, you will go outside, drink some tea, then you here and there you wander, etc. But in the UPSC, 3 hours paper you have to write. Secondly, after a gap of around 2.5 to 3 hours, you are writing the next paper. In one day, 6 hours you are writing. Next day then you have to write. Then the next day also you have to write. Then there is a gap. Then 2 more papers. Then 2 more papers. It's a long process, the mains. So be prepared for this physical taxation. Because if you are not prepared, despite of the preparation I am telling, at times you will have cramps in the hands. The last paper, while you are writing, in the third day, the second paper you will be writing in the evening. By 3 o'clock your fingers, you cannot open your fingers. I do not know whether these people are really practicing the mains test. Maybe if you want to test this, next time when you are writing, no, this full test, 2 days continuous. Try this, you will see. The second day, in the third, that is the fourth test, fourth 3 hours. After three hours you have written the fourth. When you write, you will get cramps. Plan for that also. That is possible to avoid by writing more tests now itself. Complete all writing the test. Have this practice before going to the examination. 15 days before itself you will have. All these practices you will have. This is the first thing. Physical. I am telling physical thing. There is one more important point associated with it. Is that many people think that they have to keep on writing until they go to the mains examination. That is wrong. Every day they will write 2 hours, waste of time, don't do this. Sir, until how much time you have to write? And I have done my own calculation. If you are normally writing properly every test, and if you don't write 15 days anything, then directly go and write in the mains paper 1. Then after this gap, you directly go and write mains, that is also a problem. You understand? So I am telling, latest 1 week before you write the mains examination, you should have written 3 hours continuous. So even if there is no test also, you try writing this. Second thing, 1 day before going to the mains examination, write for 40 minutes or 1 hour, write. You practice to your hand. Then on the day of the examination, nothing is needed, just because you have written 1 day before or 2 days before. Let us say the test starts on Friday or Sunday, it starts. And 2 days back, you start writing 1 hour every day, just in the morning half an hour, evening half an hour you write. Next day also you, this is called conditioning, you must know. Not many people know this, and these points nobody speaks, because it looks so small. When we speak about big things, these things become very small, but these are very important, you please understand this. So writing is very essential, get attuned to this. Second point. When you go to the examination, please remember that this mains examination, unlike preliminary examination, is not won or lost in a span of one test. It's not won or lost, because it continues minimum 7 papers. I am telling 7 papers out of the 9 papers in the mains, 7 papers contribute to the mark, and your performance in all the 7 papers are highly necessary. Ensure that only when you give your full in all these 7 papers, plus these 2 papers, the language paper and the English, you have to just get minimum marks to qualify. Only when you give your best in the 7 papers, you please presume that, presume that you will clear this mains. I have seen many students scoring high marks out of 7 in 6 papers. The one exception would be either an essay paper, or the one exception would be some other paper, for example paper 1 of the optional or any GS paper for that matter, and most important of all it will be in the third paper or whatever it is. One paper they will get 50 mark, all other paper they have done well, so that is not going to help. So the best of all the 7 papers are required. Second, that also you please understand this. If you have to give the best of all the 7, what should be your approach? Your approach should be, if you do a thing which is correct in one paper or you are wrong in one paper, don't get carried away by this hangover. Presuming in one paper you have not done well, let us say paper 1 of GS you have not done well. Two questions, the questions which are known to you, you wrongly understood, wrote it wrong. Ensure that this negativity is not carried to the next paper when you are writing. Because you don't think that, sir, I have not done well in the second, in the first GS paper, so this year I am not going to clear, etc. Don't presume this. Because when you have presumed that, this is not going to happen, it will not happen. You understand? Even if you make one mistake in any one paper, ensure that that is gone. Okay, whatever has happened. Give your best in all these 7 papers which contribute to your mark. Third aspect, I have seen in many of these mains, because after the first paper and the second paper in the afternoon you have a lot of time. Normally you see, this time instead of using fruitfully, some students, even if they don't use fruitfully, they will use negatively. I have seen this. How, sir? After writing the first paper, students will come and ask, what is the answer for this? How have you written? And they will say, this if you have not done, they will say, why you have not done? This way very easy, that was put in the test, smart test, did you not write? And there are always some students who are very hyperactive. Please, if you are not of their nature, it is better that you just migrate to the space where you are comfortable. I have seen some people trying to do everything in these 3 hours. They want to refer this book, that book, call somebody in the phone, they will call it to us and ask final minutes doubt. For some it may work, for majority it doesn't work. Unnecessarily problem it will give. So what is the best strategy? The best strategy is, after writing one paper, don't think whatever has happened. By thinking if something better is going to happen, I will ask you to think. By writing a paper, after completing GS, if you are worrying, because of the worry, if some correction can be made in the paper 1, then I will tell that you worry for 3 hours. But it is not going to happen. I know this, it is not going to happen. Now what is the best for the next paper which you go open-minded, throw away all negativity, say that, yeah, we have done our best, you have done your best in the given time and the situation, that's it. The next paper you have to do the best, that approach you go. Are we understanding? Sometimes students will try to put marks also. 20 questions they attempted and they will put the mark. For first question, 6 marks I will get. Second question, 8 I will get. Like this, after the preliminary, you have seen this. After the preliminary also they do the same. Means they will go, you will have people saying that in paper 1 I will get around 104 marks I will get. Like this they will say. Nobody knows how much you will get. And students, those who are written many mains, they also cannot say how much marks they have done, means they are going to get, because the correction, the trend, lot of variation is happening. So your job is not to put mark to yourself, your job is not to worry, your job is to plan for the next paper, and the planning includes two things, one, taking rest, otherwise preparing something associated with the subject which is coming in the next paper. This is the planning. And most important of all, I suggest that some students who often get tension by interacting with other tension people, I suggest that you remain alone, just sit calm, just go and write the examination in a very proper manner.